Right, kick off with two Scottish tunes. Actually, they're composed tunes. They were written by a fellow called Neil Gow. It was 18th century. Came from Argyllshire. He was, in fact, one of two brothers, both who played the fiddle. But his brother, who was called Nathaniel Gow, took the credit for these tunes posthumously for about 100 years, because he was a printer as well as a fiddler, and he printed these tunes, but he omitted to put Neil's name after them. So for a long time, people thought that Nathaniel Gow had composed these, but not so. We know better now. I'd say that there was two brothers and three fiddlers. I shan't say it again. First tune's called What You Are, I Met the Stream. I don't know what that means either. But you don't have to, because later on he called the same tune by another title, and he called it Lord Haddo's Favourite. Lord Haddo is the seat of Aberdeenshire. And then I'm going to follow that, God willing, if I live through it, with a tune called Lady Mary Hayes' Scotch Measure. It's a five-part crazy tune. Scotch Measure is actually a dance form, but it's a dance form that's become defunct. You can't go out and dance it anywhere. No one knows how to dance this anymore. Actually, what happened was there were too many people dying of heart attacks. And it got banned. So they are, these are composed tunes. Neil Gow.
Thank you.
close us within the tradition, I'll play you three tunes by Carolan, Turlough O'Carolan. This is a 16th century Irishman. First one's called Mrs. Birmingham, followed by one that doesn't have a title. It's number 178 though, in the Carolan book. So if you like it and you want to learn it, and you don't want a fork out of fibre for a cassette, because I'm playing stuff tonight that's on the cassette, you see. Actually, some people tried to buy the cassette outside and they couldn't. You can only buy it off me. And if you feel at any time that you'd like to buy one and you can't maybe wait till the end or you've just got to have one, I've got a little bag by the side of me and they're in there. If you'd like to come up, take one, put a fiver in. If you need change, tap me on the shoulder and I'll stop what I'm doing. Just carry on. So this is Mrs. Birmingham, 178 for want of a title. And then instead of doing a fast one to finish, I'm going to do a slow one to finish, a wonderful tune of his called Blind Mary. And Blind Mary was a contemporary of Carolan's. They both played the harp and they were both blind.
Thank you.
Nicely into a couple of English tunes, because it's about time we had some English tunes. These are from the northeast of England. First one's called The Keelman's Perdition, or rather the second one's called The Keelman's Perdition. Third one's called Show Me the Way to Wallingford. Show Me the Way to Wallingford. There were about 500 Chinese and they all laughed. The only place in the world that they didn't laugh is Wallingford. I got this first tune from a customs official in Onst. Onst is the most northern of the Shetland Islands. So I was doing a crazy weekend's work. The Friday night, I was in Italy. And I got off the plane and I was standing in the airport with Simon Nicol. And I got arrested by a dog. You know what I mean, the dog. Arrested me. And they didn't find anything, but I think the dog could tell I'd been having a good time a couple of days ago. And the dog was pretty puzzled, I mean, as was Simon, because he was all ready to go home. But I was let off. They didn't find anything. Therefore, I didn't have anything. And I did the gig. And the next night, we were in Onst, and we got various planes, but we ended up with a little four-seater jobby that came down amongst all the buffeting winds and what have you. I mean, it was really terrifying. And we got out the plane, and the wind sort of blew you sideways to be greeted by this customs man with the full fig, all the yellow, all the scrambled egg in it, and his dog. And Simon went, oh no. But it turned out the dog was a pet. And the customs man played the mouth organ. And we spent the entire afternoon in his shed. Which has got to be the first and only time I've ever done that. So the Onst wedding march. It's a good story, isn't it? He wrote. He wrote this when he was 16. He'd only been playing for 2 years when he wrote this. He was blinded by smallpox when he was 40. And he didn't play an instrument at all up until that point.